probably already guessed, there's no bigger fan of the slasher genre than yours truly. Still, amidst the landslide of grim, gritty, grungy prequels, sequels, and remakes that we've gotten over the last decade, one burning question comes to mind. Where's the fun? Yes, while monsters, murder, and mutilation have always been a mainstay of slasher cinema, lately it seems like some of the spark's gone out of it. Sure, the early entries in the world's most popular slasher franchises were deadly serious attempts to scare the pants off the audience, but it's the later entries, the ones where the carnage is dished out with a wink and a nod, that sticks most in people's minds. And while Hollywood may have forgotten that fact, it's clear that somebody hasn't. In fact, it's that twinkle in its eye that made Funhouse Massacre the best time that I had all Horror Hound weekend. Without giving too much away, Funhouse Massacre, no relation to that other carnival-based abomination, is the story of six legendary killers. And by legendary, I mean that their murders are so heinous, their misdeeds have passed into urban legend, and the killers themselves are locked away in a government black site that exists on no map. Taking a page from the Michael Myers do-it-yourself early release program, they bust out, killing everyone in the asylum, and taking over a seasonal attraction dedicated to their life and crimes. Needless to say, these guys are planning to give the guests of the attractions a Halloween they won't forget for the rest of their lives, short though they may be. And while that may sound reminiscent of any number of crappy direct-to-DVD movies, that's only because, well, it is. Still, Funhouse Massacre has three things that set it apart. First, its aforementioned sense of humor. I've seen my fair share of failed horror comedies, and most of the time, they tank not because of the buckets of blood they throw around, but because they fail to live up to the second half of the phrase, horror comedy, falling flat on their face with gags that deserve a chainsaw way more than any of the characters do. Thankfully, Funhouse Massacre manages to avoid that problem with a combination of clever writing and its other two greatest aspects, a talented cast with great delivery, and a director that makes the obviously low budget of the project look way bigger than it has any right to. To give away much more would be a sin, so I'll just stop here and tell you to get your hands on this movie as soon as it is available to you.
Some fun, and I don't go bust the bubble on the rich folks who get rich.